From the abandoned forts all across America to the creepy military hospital that saved Hitler's life, these are 9 unusual deserted military sites. Number 9, Fort Tilden. Location, New York City. Fort Tilden was an important part of the mainland USA defense system for a long while. The area had military installations dating back to the War of 1812, but it wasn't until World War I when the place got a huge upgrade. During peacetime, Fort Tilden was the lucky site for the construction of 2 16-inch M1919 guns. And when I say guns, I mean you will wish you never even thought about coming near this place type of guns. At the start of World War II, the site was fortified. Oh, so that's why they call it a fort. Good to know. To protect from aerial attacks, and got one more M1919 gun. You would think the upgrade ended after the war, but you would be wrong. During the Cold War, Fort Tilden received a bunch of 90mm and 120mm guns, essentially creating an anti-aircraft system. If that wasn't enough, the government also built 2 nuclear-capable missile launch sites, making this one of the biggest defenses against any attack on New York City. In 1970, the fort was officially decommissioned and passed off to the U.S. National Park Service. Number 8. The Johnston Atoll. Location, Pacific Ocean. There are not many places in the world that have gotten as much use from the U.S. government as the Johnston Atoll. Without getting too carried away, the small island in the Pacific has been used and abused as an airbase, a nuclear and biological weapons test site, a naval refueling depot, secret missile base, a storage unit for Agent Orange, and, of course, a bird sanctuary. The atoll was originally acquired by the United States in 1856 under the Guano Islands Act, which allowed U.S. citizens to claim any uninhabited island that had guano on it. Guano is bird poop. Yes, the government gave permission to any citizen to claim almost any island as long as they found bird poop on it. I hope there was more nuance that I'm missing. Fast forward to 1973 and you will find row after row after row of barrels filled with Agent Orange. After a few decades, the Johnston Atoll had its official last takeoff on June 15th, 2004. Everything was closed down and deserted. The place was actually put up for auction, but no one bought it, primarily because the place was contaminated beyond recovery. Number 7. The Dagat Radar Array System. Location, Ukraine and Siberia. Nicknamed by shortwave radio enthusiasts as the Russian Woodpecker because of the repetitive tapping noise it created, the Dagat Radar Array System was the USSR's way of protecting the motherland. It was probably powerful enough to detect a missile flying over the Atlantic. The thing is, for a long while, no one knew where this strange signal was coming from, and some people believed it to be a mind control device operated by the Ruskies. The signal disappeared in 1989 as quickly as it appeared in 1976. Nowadays, the Dagat-1 rises through the thick forests located uncomfortably close to the Chernobyl power plant. If you have played Stalker, then you know exactly what we're talking about here. Or maybe Call of Duty Black Ops. Seems like this place will never completely disappear from our modern culture. Or video games, at least. Number 6. The Jelava Air Base. Location, Croatia. This place was considered one of the scariest bases in former Yugoslavia. It was the largest airbase it had, and one of the largest in Europe. It is believed that the base held 2 full fighter squadrons, or about 48 fighter jets. The more interesting part of the base was the underground bunkers, capable of surviving a 20 kiloton nuclear blast and being self-sustainable for up to 30 days. After it was apparent that the Yugoslav wars of 91 were not going their way, the airbase was destroyed by the Yugoslavian government. Nowadays, it is sometimes used for police training, but its primary purpose is an awesome urban exploration spot. Number 5. The Devil's Slide Bunkers. Location, California. The Devil's Slide is an aptly named area of the Pacific coastline, close to the city of Montara. One of the hills was part of a military triangulation station designed during World War II. It served its purpose of protecting the harbor of San Francisco from the threat of a Japanese military attack. The bunker is still standing to this day, barely, but it's still there. The area is prone to landslides and heavy erosion. G chances are that the Devil's Slide Bunker will slip into the Pacific Ocean sometime soon. So pack your bags if you want to see it in person. Beware of the current owners too. The area is now private property. Number 4, RAF Stenigat. Location, England. Unfortunately, this is not the site of a downed UFO. As much as we want to believe the truth is out there, this is not it. RAF is an acronym for the British Royal Air Force, and the Stenigat site was a radar station used for the early detection of Nazi air raids. After the war, the Stenigat got a major facelift and the four dishes that we see in these pictures as part of the ACE High program. ACE High stands for Allied Command Europe, and it was a radio communication system created by NATO in 1956. As the years passed, there was less and less need for this location. It was officially decommissioned in the late 80s. But still, it looks pretty strange from afar. What do you think they got under there? Number 3, the Cape May Bunker. Location, New Jersey. Don't you just hate it when you go to the beach and the only available spots to relax are right next to the abandoned World War II era bunker? Yeah, me too. The official name for this structure is Batter 223. It was built between the World Wars as part of the modernization of the Coastal Defense Program. This bunker sports 6-foot-thick walls that were ready to take direct hits from any enemy battleship. Luckily, the bunker was never put to good use. There are no plans of destroying the bunker, so it's safe to say that it will remain on the beaches of New Jersey for quite a long time. Number 2, the Stanley R. Mickelson Safeguard Complex. Location, North Dakota. SRMSC, for short, is probably one of the most interesting things you can see in North Dakota, the state that boasts the title of least visited state in the union. But hey, they also have the lowest unemployment rate in the country, so I guess it's even Stevens. Anyway, back to the base. This place was a crucial USA defense location, holding 30 Spartan anti-ballistic missiles capable of intercepting nuclear warheads 400 plus miles away, and another 70 Sprint short-range anti-ballistic missiles. The site was first operational on April 1, 1975, and was deactivated on February 10, 1976. This complex cost over $6 billion to build and operated for less than a year. That's about $545,454,545 per month. Hoo-wee! Number 1, the Beilitz-Hallstatten Military Hospital. Location, Germany. The Beilitz-Hallstatten Hospital complex was huge. It had about 60 operational buildings and served its purpose during both world wars. The most famous patient of the hospital is, without a doubt, Adolf Hitler. He recuperated injuries sustained during the Battle of the Somme in World War I. After the destruction of Nazi Germany, the hospital became part of the Red Army and was fully operational until 1994. None of the abandoned buildings have been demolished or restored for that matter. It gives the whole complex a eerie vibe. Do you think you have the guts to explore this abandoned complex at night during a full moon while you're being followed by Nazi zombies? Yeah, didn't think so. And don't forget to like and subscribe. For more awesome content, check out this video.